We need speed in about 10 seconds. How's the beta deck?
Beta deck's happening.
Okay, Cookie, we need names.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Okay. Hang on.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, everybody, I need to focus. Let's do a...
1, 2, 3.
Contestants, how you doing? Welcome to our show.
What's up,
Why don't you tell me how many people are going to be playing this?
I'll do two.
Excellent selection. Now, player one, could you give us your name?
So, that'll be me.
Okay, Singer.
You guys got that in there?
Yeah.
Can you use your 19, please?
Hey, Carl.
Thanks. Now, player two, how about your
name? My God, this is so weird. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, all right, that's what I needed to know.
Shit, Grimith's gonna kick my ass. All right, I got Q. Fuck.
While you're ahead.
Not fuck.
Player two, you buzz in on the letter P, as in peaches.
Peaches.
Can I get some tea?
Yeah.
I can do a peach.
What kind do you want?
There's no way we can load all this.
This is great. Thanks for thinking this.
Whoa, hello. All right, you're gonna get a bunch of questions. First person to hit their buzzer
Shut
gets
up,
first. Shut Oh God, am I boring you? Boy, I wouldn't want to do that. Hey, we better start. Somebody's in a real hurry.
What are we doing? The name of this category is Maybe You Do Know Jack. Okay, shouldn't be too tough. This question's gonna be worth a grand. Alright, maybe you do know a few of them. Let's find out. Which of the following is not a famous type of jack? A deposit of tiny ice crystals, a handheld pneumatic machine for drilling, a solid food made from pressed milk curds, or a prosthetic scrotum? Player one, go nuts! You never heard of Jack Frost? Who's been nipping at your nose?
Damn it!
Player two, go. A solid food made from pressed milk curds, like Jack Cheese. Sorry, your answer is Nebula.
I bet he's four.
Should have picked this.
Two.
A phony scrotum, which is not a famous jack. It's really more of a sack.
I thought Jack and all, but it's a scrotum.
Category.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Whoop-de-doo, it's question number two.
Here's the category.
All right, lowest score wins, guys.
You get this one right, you got 2,000 bucks coming at you. Okay, hang tight. Put your fingers on your buzzers. Here's the question.
I had to press the screen.
If Porky Pig were processed along parameters previously prescribed by the pork industry, which of the following products would probably not be procured? Brushes, toupee.
Shit!
Player one, it's in your hands now.
Fuck.
A hairpiece product for the follically challenged?
Yeah! Nice.
That'd really make you pig-headed. Oh, that's right, I almost forgot. Player two. Tough luck.
Oh, shit!
Counter-screwed me.
Counter-screwed.
Player one, pick one.
I gotta do this.
The category is, Wherefore Art Thou a Cokehead? And we will pay out $3,000 for this one. Hang on tight, because here we go. In a bizarre test of manhood, four Shakespearean characters try to do a line of cocaine for every line of dialogue written for them. Who will have to snort the most coke? Hamlet, Macbeth, Othello, or Richard III? Got a buzz
How
in?
Do I screw you?
Hey, block it! Wrong key! Go for it, player two. Ouch. Player one, the ball's in your court. What do you want to do with it?
You know what? I'm going to try it.
Go! Go for it, player one. Yeah, Richard could brag to the other patients at the Betty Ford Clinic that he'd done 1,124 lines of coke, but at least one other guy there wouldn't be impressed.
Aww.
You know what you could have picked? You could have picked this. Hamlet would have to do 1,422 lines of coke. Of course, by that time, he'd also be able to stick his finger in one nostril and have a poke out the other. Let's have a category, player two.
That's not my favorite rendition question.
The category behind this question
four.
Is a little wisdom from Grandpa. And this one's going to be worth $2,000. Okay, we're coming at you. Heads up. Your Grandpa Bob is a walking encyclopedia. If you ask him who's responsible for inventing dentures, what should he tell you? I have George Washington to thank for that. Player one. I have the Etruscans to thank for that. That's right, dentures were worn by Etruscans back in 700 BC, and they came up with polydent a few years later.
You're back at zero. Nicely done.
Yeah, thank you. I'm a man who likes fire.
Next up, short order cooks and men who like fire. and this one's gonna be worth $3,000. Flight attendants, prepare for takeoff. If Greek mythology's Prometheus and Mel from Alice opened a diner, what would they logically specialize in? Soul food, liver and chili.
Oh yeah. Smart. Well,
Mel makes chili, and Prometheus gets his liver eaten by an eagle for eternity.
Soup slime.
Category player two. Uh-oh, mess butt tit slime chore.
No, I'm not good at these, so.
All right, let me see if I can get one I remember from my childhood.
The category for this gibberish question, ash and cash. $5,000 is the opening value for this gibberish question. Okay, now remember, you don't have all the time in the world here. The less time you take, the more money you make. Okay, what famous commercial phrase does this rhyme with? Be Baked Bunny, behold Ash Wednesday.
Oh no!
And number one, it's a corporate slogan. It's a very unusual slogan.
I remember the first part, I can't remember the second one.
It's a slogan for an investment company.
No!
Last hint, they really earn their money.
Son of a bitch!
Looks like you really lose your money.
No, I don't know. We'll find out.
We make
well,
money.
You didn't earn your money.
The old-fashioned way.
We splurn it.
Damn it.
Nice.
Okay, we need a category. Your pick, player two. All right, let's see what we're doing here. Zoinks, forsooth. This question's gonna be worth 2,000 $1 bills. Okay, let's get this ball rolling. Which of the following is not true about both Hamlet and Scooby-Doo? They both spent a lot of time in castles, they both knew someone named Daphne, they both saw ghosts, or they were both Great Danes.
Shit.
Uh-uh, give me a... Daphne, Ophelia, what's the diff?
Yeah.
That's
there's
what I was thinking.
Yeah.
I was hoping you'd screw me.
Well, I don't know the button to screw. What is it?
I guess we should have watched the intro.
Yeah.
It's S.
Oh, S. Okay. I'll remember that in the future.
Yeah. You buzz in, then you press S.
Sweet. Oh, I buzz in, then press S. Okay.
Yeah.
This one's going to be, don't stick that there. And we are talking 1,000 bucks for this question. Hope you're ready, because here's one coming at you. Which of the following would be most likely to hit a uvula? A broom handle, a tongue depressor, a Polish farmer, or a... So sweet, so dobrze, you stupid uvula. The accent threw you off, didn't it?
Are you insane?
A tongue depressor. The uvula, that little punchy bag thing in your throat.
I loved his answer to that. That was amazing. Oh,
so
shit.
So rewarding picking the wrong answer.
Yeah, don't regret it. Oh, that's amazing.
Here's the category. It's every man's dream. And this one's gonna be worth $1,000. Okay, get your fingers ready, let's get busy. If you wanted to be a little taller and a little thinner immediately, which environment should you simulate in your home? The ocean floor, a rainforest, a cave, or outer space? You gotta answer it, player two. A rainforest? That's if you want to be a little hotter and a little wetter. Actually, that sounds pretty good.
It does sound pretty good.
Player one, the ball's in your court. What do you want to do with it?
Oh, I don't know. I'll
player
try.
One, go nuts.
Taller and thinner outer space.
In weightlessness, your spine straightens and your intestines ride up. You could become an inch
Thank
taller,
you, Chris Hadfield, for teaching me that.
Wait until Jenny Craig finds out about this.
Ocean floor would make it shorter.
Yeah. Yeah, it's squishy.
Player one, give me a category.
Oh, I gotta do this one.
The category. Thanks for the memories. And it looks like you can win 1,000 greenbacks for this one. Get your eyes focused on the screen. Here we go. If TV detective Frank Cannon gave up the life of crime by didn't open up an anti-health food store.
Oh, what? Am I dropping frames? Oh, I might be. Well, it doesn't look like it. Maybe there's a slight hiccup.
Milk might be stocked because it has the highest fat content.
I was
sheep,
curious
buffalo,
whether it were.
Or human.
Yeah, I don't think so.
The network is spluttering. The parsec network is spluttering into...
Actually, what you should have guessed is reindeer. Reindeer milk
has
about
parsec. Wait, give me a second. Okay, looks normal.
Fans as much fat as a cow's. I wonder if that might explain Santa Claus's little weight problem.
Just a parsec issue, then.
Okay, yeah, maybe. The end of round one now. On
Chad
round
is saying
two.
That it was derping out a bit.
Oh, so yeah, it was my internet. It probably had a bit of a spike.
Okay, here we go. One for everyone.
Marsec is telling me, network seems to be slow. Please stand by.
All the questions in this round are going to be worth more than a round one. So pay attention, and let's do it.
And then it is closed. Without my input.
Oh, it's closed?
Yep, it closed itself.
Oh, no! All right, don't worry. I can always add you. Well, you could actually click that link, same link again, I bet you, because it's good for an hour. I paused the game.
I will absolutely try to click that link again, yeah.
Sweet.
You betcha.
You betcha. This is great. I gotta get Lethal in on this too. At some point when he's free.
The technology works.
It
the
does.
Proof is in the pudding.
Kind of. Except when it doesn't let me press the check mark button. Oh, now it does. There we go. My upload speed's I can't remember. I can't measure it, but it's good. The problem is
you can't measure it, it's that big.
Pretty much.
In big in your internet speed today.
Yes. All right.
There's a topical cream for that.
There is. All right. Will it work for you now, Grimith? Yeah, it will.
And now, oh, we're on 11. Did you answer 12?
The category
10 correctly?
Is Sanford and Son.
No, I just saw the timeout.
And we are talking 4,000 big ones. Get ready to buzz, because here it comes. To prevent yourself from ever having what he termed the big one, what should Fred Sanford take to control his heart palpitation? Kerosene, bleach, nitroglycerin, or hydrochloric acid? Go for it. Nitroglycerin. Small amounts of it dilate blood vessels, increasing blood supply.
Huh, I thought that would have done the opposite
for
his heart.
Of it, Fred will get the really, really big one.
Oh, my heart!
Inferno, master of trivia.
Yeah, apparently.
Player one, pick one.
Uh-oh,
oh no!
Butts fits mine whore.
Inferno
again,
cleaning the floor with the Clorox. Tinker, lick test drum. Mm-mm.
This gibberish question's category is tight asses and oppositional thinking.
Whoa, 10,000 monies.
This question is going to be 10,000 bucks.
Yeah, that's
now,
great.
You're going to have about 30 seconds to solve this puzzle, but I'm going to be taking a little bit of money away every second and a half. Now, you know there's no screwing your neighbor in this kind of a question. You ready to untangle some gibberish? Let's do it. What does this rhyme with? Very scary, tight bun, berry.
Oh.
It's from a nursery rhyme. Tight bun berry. I don't recall that nursery rhyme. A nursery rhyme about a girl.
Oh.
Go for it. Type it in and
quite contrary. Very good. Hey, you broke even.
Very scary. Tight bun berry. Cow buzz war hard and blow.
Can you help me out here with something? What the hell are cockle shells? And why are they talking about them in a nursery rhyme?
True, I did too.
Player two, pick one.
Well, there's plenty of time left.
There's like 21 fucking questions here.
The name in this category is, see if you can say this three times fast. I'm paying out $2,000 if you get this one right. Okay, get yourself set. It's time. If the score is 4-2, what is the score? 40-20? 50, player 80-40.
Thank you, Abe Lincoln.
A score equals 20. Okay, we need a category. Your pick, please.
Sweat up just everything.
Next up, ho-ho, who the hell are you? And this one should be too tough. 4K for this one. Okay, let's get this ball rolling.
I love how he delivers
these
lines.
According to Pennsylvania Dutch tradition, if it's New Year's Eve and you come downstairs to find a fat man leaving cookies on a plate, don't bludgeon him with an iron poker because he is Santa's brother, Bell. Santa Claus giving back cookies.
Oh, okay. I'm going to guess. Oh, fuck!
Player two, if you want it, it's yours.
Staying the fuck away from this one.
Yeah.
Is the tradition? No.
Now, the correct answer is... That's Saint
really?
Bell, Bells. Now, he's a little slow, but he's got a heart of gold, so Santa gave him the gig to keep him out of trouble.
Huh.
Makes sense.
You learn.
Let's have a category, player two. The category behind this question is U.S. presidents on Let's Make a Deal. A right answer will get you two G's for this question. Okay, we're coming at you. Heads up. If you were on Let's Make a Deal and you turned down four bills with Grant's picture on them for just one with Lincoln's, what kind of deal did you make and why? A bad deal because you lost money, bad deal because there's no bill with Grant on it, good deal because you made money, or didn't matter because amounts are the same.
Put Grimith on the spot.
Two, you're getting screwed. Make Grant's on the 50, Lincoln's on the 5.
Okay.
You would have lost money.
Because I had no idea. Oh, shit, we're tied.
You could have thrown Monty in jail for counterfeiting. Player one, that's right. I got some bad news for you,
pal. Oh, wait, we're not tied.
No, not tied anymore.
Backfired. That's right, Grimith.
Category, player two, let's do it. Flush your head down the
latrine. They're really trying to make these things rhyme.
This one's gonna be
flush your head down the
latrine and the open road. You get this one right, ooh, you got $2,000 coming at you. Hang on tight, cause here we go. Which of the following might Julius Caesar have regularly driven across in his chariot? An oviduct, a viaduct, an aqueduct, or a mallard duct? Go for it, player.
Damn.
Run over a water pathway? Maybe in his cigarette speedboat, but not in his chariot.
Oh, shit.
Player two, you went a viaduct.
Whew.
Yeah, the Romans had some pretty serious
engineering. I pressed P right before you pressed your button. Yeah. I was like, no, host privilege.
No.
What do you say, player two? How about it? All right, let's see what we're doing here. Your love is like bad medicine. And if you can figure this one out, I can pay you $4,000. Okay, hang tight. Put your fingers on your buzzers. Here's the question. If TV's Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman decides that her beloved Sully is in need of trephining, what is she going to do to him? She's going to drill a hole in his skull.
Nice.
Yeah.
And my guess is she's not going to find anything in there. Player one, it's up to you. What are we doing?
What about Bob?
What about Bob? What about him?
The name in this category is What About Bob? I'm paying out $2,000 if you get this one right. Flight attendants, prepare for takeoff. If Bob gets a hat trick with a wrister, what is Bob doing? Go for it, player one. In hockey terms, Bob's wrist
fuck yeah
is his third goal of the game.
That's right. Fucking hat
no
trick, buddy.
Was...
if you were
getting
no.
You had no hope.
Legs, that would be something else entirely.
It's like the question
player
about money directed my way.
Yes, exactly. This one.
The category. Hurry, before the commercial's over. It's going to be worth $4,000. Get ready to buzz, because here it comes.
Mm.
Let's say you got a TV when it was first invented in 1926, and you refused to go to the bathroom until a commercial came on. How long would you have had to wait? 1 year,
so
5 years,
when do they put
10
in
years,
commercials?
Or 15 years.
I'm not gonna gamble on this. Fuck this. We're too close.
Shit. I'm not gonna front class either. I think
and
it's four.
Here's the right
I think
answer.
It's two.
You would have had to wait 15 years to go. But looking on the bright side, no infomercials either. Player one, give me a category.
Got to. Wow, honey. It's all question right. Number 20.
Here's the category. The best thing going between two buns. This question's gonna be worth $2,001 bills.
Lude.
Hope you're ready, cause here's one coming at you. Which fast food chain advertised their burgers as hot and juicy? White Castle, Burger King.
This is like back in the 80s and 90s. I don't know. Fuck it. I'm gonna risk it. Damn it.
Player two, if you want it, it's yours.
Alright, maybe White Castle.
Too bad you didn't pick this. Wendy is hot and juicy.
Alright, we're coming in for the Jack Attack.
We are. Alright. You know what? 3 is the magic number.
That's what Planescape Torment taught me.
Yes! Oh shit, yeah. We can skip the instructions, yeah.
Jack attack time. You already know what you're doing.
We do.
Make sure your match fits this clue. 3 is the magic number.
Okay.
Put your fingers on your buzzers. Get yourself ready to fire. Here we go.
Oh. Oh shit, you have a good response. Oh fuck. Oh sh- no! There we go. I redeemed myself.
I don't know that trio.
Me neither.
The advantage is in my court, though, folks. The hurdle will have to guess.
Oh.
Pretty much, kids.
Yeah, you got it. What? This is pretty well... Alright, fuck it. Nope. You got her. Oh, that was a little Joe, apparently.
I don't know what that's from, Chad. You racked it up in that jack attack, but let's see your final score!
Good job.
Congratulations, Player 2. You must feel like you're on top of the world.
So I
I'm
do.
I'm gonna shoot you right down. You don't know
Jack. Well, that was delightful.
Yeah, how about that?
And that worked quite well.
Yep. I can hear myself, and there's a very slight delay, but as you can see during that jack attack, I was delayed.
Yeah.
Okay?
You were clicking them just right when I was, and I was all set for it, so that's really interesting.
There you go. Yeah, that's an example of parsec at work.
Yeah, that is. I'm pretty impressed with that. I don't know if you want to go another round or if you just want to, you're cool with it, but it's up to you there.
I'm cool with it. I can leave you to go about the rest of your stream having learned and loved, and I've learned and loved.
Yeah, we've all learned and loved. All right. Well, thank you, Grimith. I'm going to turn you off now. Well, I don't want to kick or report
you. I'll turn myself off.
Okay, yeah, just turn yourself off. Thanks, Grim. I don't want to kick him. I don't want to report him. Maybe I'll just stop hosting. That's what I'll do. Where's my hosting options? Disable. Oh, there's still guests connected to my computer. Ah, there we go. Thank you. Perfect. They are booed. I did get wrecked at the end. All right. Days when you raided your folks' wet bar for booze. We gotta listen to these ads.
Now someone's stealing from your liquor cabinet.
You
he
did,
lives
Grimith.
In your house, calls your dad. Booze.
Booze.
There was a time when your kids were nursed at home with mother's milk. Now they're on your doorstep nursing 40 ounces of malt liquor.
Booze.
It used to be that you never saw your family except at dinner time. Now you all go to AA meetings together.
Take a swig from the elixir of life. Have a drink of booze. Have a drink of booze.
Sponsored by the American Council on Booze Consumption.
Hey, kid, what you eating?
Oh, just some stuff my mom made me eat. Burlap sack cereal. Supposed to be good for you.
Yuck! Smells like crap. Give me your bowl. Try some of these.
Mmm. Chocolicious num-num bits. Hey, my tongue is numb.
Honey, who are you talking to?
Whoa! Got a split, kid. Eat up.
Don't go, Shocky. I need you.
Yeah, got my beeper. Got a motor.
Hey, guys. When you go to the store, are you sick of seeing rows and rows of little pink packages labeled just for women? It used to be a man's world. What the hell happened?
I remember this commercial. It's amazing.
Man packs. Feminine hygiene products made just for men. Constructed from an indestructible space-age polymer, Man Packs products are perfect for the man on the go. And they only come in one color. Camouflage! Look for Man Packs products anywhere you buy beer. Man Packs. Put the men back in menstruation. Period.
It's hard as a single mother to find a job that fits in with motherhood. The folks at Memory Lane Dairies let me do that.
Memory Lane Dairy Farms, makers of Mama's Pride human breast milk.
I like working at Mama's Pride because I feel like I'm really doing some good for people. Every customer's like one of my children.
Providing good nutrition and good jobs for people like Bessie. And that makes good sense.
It's wholesome, it's natural, and I don't have to worry about giving it to my kids, because I know where it came from. Out of me.
Mama's Pride Fresh Breast Milk. Baby yourself with Mama's Pride.
Oh my God, that was amazing. Oh my God. All right, open invitation to anyone else who wants to play. As you can tell, it's pretty... All you have to do is, install a Parsec program and just sign up. All you need to do, username, email. And it works pretty darn well. Of course, I'd only do people that I trust. Even though if I just gave you keyboard control, you don't need to look at my... Well, it doesn't really matter. It's no big deal. But, open invitation... I forgot about that period part. Otherwise, this might be something that'll be great for me to organize in the future. Oh, wait, I gotta have something here. There we go. Oh, I know, who'd have thought? Yeah. Yeah. Trust me, it's nothing all that exciting. There's plenty of controls, right? Anyway, but this might be something to get together with some folks, plan ahead of time. Be like, hey, do you want to play some Jack Attack? I could see Lethal being pretty good at this game, too, so I'll bug him later on about that. Axion. Jesus, that'd be funny. Yeah, lots of opportunity. Well, it looks like no one's jumping at the opportunity, which is more than fine. I think I might play... fuck it. I'll play one more round of You Don't Know Jack, because I think it's funny, and then I'll probably wind her down. Yee. That's exactly what I'll do. Alright. Oh! I gotta get my... Oh. Alright, it's working. Great.
Okay, go for Helen.
lose the foie gras and the craft services table and start getting a hunk of a good old American cheese.
You got it. Okay, stand by. Cookie, can I have some names, please?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody. Nate, I need a sound check from you.
10987654. Blah.
Hey, contestants, how you doing? Glad
good.
You could be here. How many people do we have playing today? You're a single player, is that right? All right, could you give me your name, please?
I'm going to bite your nails, but I don't want to do that in the middle of the show or something. I just want to cut it off.
Little hypo.
Good, Becca.
Oh, yeah. Are you looking for a 7-question? Tadazin, gotcha. Your
seconds.
Buzzer is the letter B, as in Betty bakes me bread.
Bread.
Oh, we're holding you up, huh? Okay. Hey, let's get the ball rolling here.
Cookie, are we going right now?
Yeah, you got a problem with that?
What?
All right, let's go.
All right, come on, hit me. We need a category. All right, let's see what we're doing here. B movies for the cultural elite.
Keep track of this at home and see how well you would do.
Greenbacks for this one. Say you want to make a low-budget horror film based on a literary classic.
Okay.
In your adaptation, a man kills his dad, marries his mom, and protects Japan from destruction. What would be a good title?
Oh, that's easy.
It's all Oedipus meets Godzilla. I don't know. I think a better plot line would have been Godzilla's mom keeping a Japanese bus's speed above 50 so it won't explode. Okay, pick a category. This one's gonna be afraid, be very afraid. A right answer will get you 2 G's for this question. Keeping kids from seeing gore-filled horror films is probably a pretty good idea, but it's not the only source of graphic violence available to children. Death by devouring, boiling, cannibalism, and the cutting of the human body in half can also be found where? The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, an average sample of 200 nursery rhymes, a comic book version of the King James Bible, or Old Yeller?
Jesus, it's either 2 or 3. I'm gonna go with this. Oh, okay.
Should have picked this.
Oh god! Lethal!
200 nursery rhymes. About half will lull you to sleep, the other half will give you nightmares. Maybe you should just let your kids watch cable.
Lethal. Lethal.
How about...
Lethal, I was just talking about you. Also, do you like the jackpacks? I know, we're the tiniest jackbox on Twitch. But, Grimith and I just tested out playing the game, this single-player game, using a program called, what's it called, Parsec? And it worked out quite well. So if you ever want to flex your trivia skills in front of the internet, you let me know, and we can play. Because I has all the old-school jacks. You don't know jacks. What else do I have? Don't give me a second. Library games. I got like Jack volume like 1 to 6 plus movies, sports, television, and Head Rush. He's open invitation. Not putting you on the spot now.
I did hit me with the category.
Ooh-wee, here's question number 3.
Here's the category.
And
we are talking $1,000 for this question. Okay, hang tight. Put your fingers on your buzzers. Here's the question. All right, let's say you want to end it all by jumping off the top of a New York skyscraper. Which of the following buildings will give you the most airtime to regret your decision? Yeah, you can wet yourself quite a few times falling 102 stories.
Yay.
All right, come on, hit me. We need a category.
Yeah, fair enough. We'll go this.
Uh-oh, best butts fits mine whore.
It's time for a ticklish pastime.
If only there was a Simpsons version, you and I could go head-to-head on that.
The category for this gibberish question? Who's that lurking over there? $5,000 is the opening value for this gibberish question. Okay, to solve this puzzle, you gotta think fast because every second and a half, I'm ticking off a little bit of cash. Here we go. With what song does this rhyme? 5. Seen lurking. I'm
out.
Can't see what you got, sir. Type. Get out your picks and shovels.
5. Seen lurking on the way out. Call the FDA.
You know, what's that Dinah won't you blow part about anyway? Okay, pick a category.
Question 5.
Next up, whom are you calling a homophone? Pop a right answer for this one, you got 3,000 greenbacks. Okay, get your fingers ready, let's get busy. If careless carries carries where the cross he had to carry, what more would you know about Carrie than you already care to know? Elf and friends are a burden to him, his relatives are mean to him, tooth decay is his biggest problem, or he has fathered children out of wedlock.
What?
Here's what you should have guessed. Tooth decay is his biggest problem. A carry is tooth decay.
Oh.
How about it? Hit me with a category.
Gotta be quick.
Get in the mix.
The category is Ride Aunt Sally Ride. And this one's gonna be worth $2,000. Okay, we're coming at you, heads up. You're in high school taking a math test. Your friend whispers,
please excuse my dear Aunt Sally.
What is your friend telling you? She has a crypt sheet under her desk. She has a fake hall pass to leave the class, the order of mathematic operations, or the Pythagorean theorem.
Oh, I bet you.
Your friend's telling you the order you should work on a math problem. Parentheses, exponents, multiply, divide, add, subtract. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. She's had a little too much beef jerky. All right, come on, hit me. We need a category.
He's a Jack Attack.
Time for the attack. Buzz Buzz in when two words match, and you got 2,000 bucks. Buzz in when there isn't a match, and you lose 2,000. And don't forget, it's not any old match we're looking for. It's the one that fits this clue. Stop, or I'll shoot. Okay, this is it, final round. Let's see what you can do. Begin the attack.
Oh, ink, I betcha. Remember the clue.
Venom! Your wad. Zesty tomato sauce. Dargan! Fire. Yeah. Chili. Sloths. Oh. Yeah, it worked very well. Yeah, the delay is really great. Spit. It worked quite well. Oh shit, you could too, Lethal! Oh my god, you could. So when I do, when I play Poly Bridge, and I fuck it up, and I'm like, Lethal, what are you talking about? You just be like, shut the fuck up, Inferno. Let me take control of the mouse, and then you show it.
Fabulous. Trivia geek with no social life. Stuff like that. But don't thank me, because the real truth is...
No.
You don't know Jack.
Gay for me. And now we get to listen to these awesome, awesome commercials.
Great show, everyone. Really, really great work. Cookie, contestants, what's the plan?
All right, if you want to play again, you just got to let me know whenever you're ready, okay?
It's the new Major Dick action figure. You choose the assignment, Major Dick does the dirty work. Pretend Major Dick is on a peacekeeping mission in a third world nation.
Major Dick, there's trouble over there. Looters!
I'll have to let you drop that loaf of bread, punk!
I'm so very hungry.
Too late, slime ball.
Thanks, Major Dick. I'll take care of that woman. She's
damn straight,
brother.
Sorry, dirtbag. Show me your receipt next time. Major Dick action figure. Uzi sold separately.
You've climbed the ladder of success as high as it will take you, and you deserve a chair, no, a throne that is worthy of your upper esh tush.
Execu-throne.
Made from the finest Corinthian leather and hardiest Chinese porcelain known to man, the Execu-throne permits you to stay at your desk 24 hours a day, so you won't lose those important business calls if nature should happen to call.
Hello? No, that's not what I said. I said sell. Marge, get in here. I need you to take a letter.
Yeah, I know. It's a teeny box.
That pot roast for lunch. Good.
Although, food. I could always use some fucking goddamn stream wizardry and do like this. Oh my gosh. Look. Uh-oh. Look, oh my god, look at that now! Now we listen to more commercials. My prodding worked!
I've got my Execu-throne. Thanks, Execu-throne.
The Execu-throne, for when you're too busy to do your business anywhere else.
Hi, it's me, Tammy.
Hi, Tammy.
And this time I have something really special for you.
Uh-huh.
That's right, a throbbing, aching, oozing bunion, not to mention painful corns, blisters, and an ingrown toenail.
Tammy,
oh,
please stop.
Do my feet stink. You like that, don't you?
No.
Don't you wish you could massage my tender, swollen
no.
feet right now?
No.
Don't you wish you could
no.
suck on my
no.
rough and gnarled toes?
No.
You can.
No.
Just dial 976-CORN. But please, do it now. There's some fungus with your name on it. Call me.
Oh my! This Chippy Monk's breakfast cereal's too sharp and crunchy, boy. Ah, it is causing my dried up gums to become very painful. Ooh.
Wow!
Hey, old timer. I feel your brain. So quit flapping your jaws and try my latest breakfast treat made especially for seniors. New chalky brand Gummy Yum Yums. Pre-chewed calcium balls fortified with massive doses of diuretics. So they come out just as easily as they go in. Here, Gramps. Gum some of this.
How diggity. How do you do, Chucky? It's like chewing on a pink and tarty cotton ball. Mmm, chocolicious.
And don't forget, Methuselah, it'll kickstart those bowels of yours and make you feel like a teenager again.
Ooh, thank you, Chucky.
Yeah, well, don't forget to light a match, Moses. Got a motor!
Wow. Okay, well, now it's all zoomed in. I gotta try
okay,
one more.
We're on. Listen.
One more, and then I'm wrapping it up, damn it.
Alrighty, good luck on your next one. People, let's make it happen.
How about it?
For sure.
Category. The category.
Just one more game.
One more crook won't make a difference.
Wait, let's look at the screen. Oh my god, that's so much bigger. I hope you're also happy now. Okay, let me move that. All right, that should be good.
And this one's going to be worth $1,000. Okay, in a never-before-seen episode of The Jeffersons, George decides to get into politics. George decides that politics is a crooked business, so he's justified in using bribes to get into office. What political theory is he demonstrating? A true Machiavellian thinks any means is acceptable for gaining power. Now,
good.
If George goes too
good.
Far, he'll be moving
I'm
on
glad
to
you're
a
happy.
Deluxe apartment on Rikers Island. Okay, pick a category.
Boop.
The name in this category is The Facts of Life. This question's gonna be worth 2,000 $1 bills. Okay, get yourself set, it's time. Natalie and Tootie from The Facts of Life have decided to become professional boxers. If they each bulk up to 176 pounds, what professional weight class will they fight
what
in?
What is 176?
Heavyweight, welterweight, lightweight, or middleweight?
I'm gonna say middle.
Middleweight? How about dead weight?
Aww.
You know what you could have picked? You could have picked this.
Really?
Heavyweight. Once you're over 175 pounds, you're in. I'll tell you, those second
I thought it was
and third helpings of Mrs. Garrett's mashed potatoes really paid off for those guys.
I thought heavyweights were like big motherfuckers.
All right, come on, hit me. We need a category.
Question three. Oh my
the category God. Behind this question is bread and other bodily functions. And we will pay out $3,000 for this one. Okay. Get your eyes focused on the screen. Here we go. Obeying the German translation, what should you do after eating pumpernickel bread? Burp, pee, fart, or lick your lips?
Pumpernickel. I have no idea.
Too bad
burp.
You didn't pick this. Fart. Pumpern means to break wind.
Oh.
How about it? Hit me with the category. Uh-oh. Test Nut Slick Crime Store.
It's time for a...
Liquor Kiss No Scope.
Ah, good to know, Kiski.
All right, now here's your category for this gibberish question. Starvation and insect marital troubles. Opening value on this gibberish question, $5,000.
Snickerlish.
Now, you're going to have about 30 seconds to solve this puzzle, but I'm going to be taking a little bit of money away every second and a half. Now, remember, there's no screwing on gibberish questions. Oh, ready? Put your fingers on your buzzers and tell me, what does this rhyme with? Climb no sungry, fly should beat divorce.
Climb no sungry, fly should...
First clue, people with big appetites say this.
Eyes bigger than your...
They say
stomach?
When a regular steak just won't do. They want something more. We are talking about unbridled...
I got it.
Type in your answer. I tell you something, I am starving. Climb no sungry. Flash should beat the boss. You know, one time I said this when I was at a stable, and nobody thought it was funny. Okay, pick a category.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Here's the category. Rodents and nomads. Okay, shouldn't be too tough. This question's going to be worth a grade.
I don't think I'm going to beat my
Toronto
last score.
Was once called York. New York was once called New Amsterdam. Hamsters are related to beavers, which build dams. Istanbul was once called Marmara.
Is that Turkey
or Constantinople? Constantinople.
Istanbul is not Constantinople. Istanbul.
Originally named after Constantine the Great, and that's no Istanbul. All right, come on, hit me. We need a category.
I gotta be a juvenile.
Number six.
Next up, look, there's Uranus. Right here, 1,000
Uranus
for a right answer. Hope you're ready, because here's one coming at you. What is a black hole? A term for all Disney movies from the 70s, a dead planet, a hole in space that has no gravity, or a collapsed star that only emits... Hello? Anybody there?
What?
And
oh, it should have been four.
Right answer. Collapsed stars
shit.
So dense that only X-rays can escape
shit,
their
poop.
Pole.
Well.
How about it? Hit me with the category.
My guy. It's all crappity, nerd. Well, you know what? Put your fucking money where your mouth is, boyo.
Cause you got a jack.
Magnus Cat, hello.
Focus for me. Here's your clue. My guy.
My guy.
That's it. Two little words, that's your hint. Load
that's
it
my clue.
And lock it in, cause here we go.
I don't know what? I don't know who's up with Pinky. I don't know. The Fonz. Alright. Oh, Ken. Alright, where's Ken? Skipper. There we go. I don't know. I don't... Oh, from the Wonder Years. What was that guy's kid's name? Kevin Arnold. I don't know. This is all shows from like the 70s and 80s. We don't know. Oh, shit. Oh, Linus. I don't know. I give up. I need to have at least something. Well, just listen to the music and the ads. Magnus Cat, how the heck are ya? Okay, Linus. Grand.
Claire, as my daddy once told me, you did good. Of course, 5 minutes later, he told me I had my head up my butt. So don't get cocky, cuz...
You don't know Jack.
Hey, Cookie, what's the deal with the contestants today?
Listen, excuse me. Whenever you feel like playing again, you just gotta let me know, all right?
All right, that's time again.
Whoa. Hey, you kids, quit nibbling at my head. Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
Come on, Chalky. Just let us nibble on you. You're chalk-tastic.
No way. Try to catch me, you crazy kids. Whoa!
You crazy chipmunk. Everyone knows that fruity choco corn puppies are for children because they're chalk-tastic.
This week on Space Trek.
Captain, the shields aren't holding, the holodeck is malfunctioning, and the replicators are making dog food or something out of the time continuum.
Good gracious, have you tried a tachyon burst?
Yes.
Phase disruptor array.
Yes.
Replicated lateral hollow injector coils with lemon.
Yes, but nothing seems to work, and now my alien Ford is morphing again.
What we need is a new vocabulary word. There's only 5 minutes left in this episode. Does anyone have any ideas?
Captain, I can't...
Wolfrar, thanks for following.
won't do. We can't afford a two-part episode.
What about the Machina way? Deus ex machina.
No, Lieutenant. It needs to be late 20th century pseudoscientific, like quasi-dimensional EMF or...
Wait, I've got it.
Well, say it. No one's going to hurt you.
No, I can't think under pressure.
Captain, I am sensing great commotion on the bridge.
Yeah, I got it.
Well, okay. We'll do one more. Should I do one more solo, or does anyone want to do one more with Inferno? And then for reals, then we're done, because then I'll be around like 7 o'clock my time, and I'll get something to eat.
Excessive smoking and drinking got you down? Not a problem. Liver crawling with billions of deadly microbes? Don't worry about it. We got livers, we got kidneys, we got lungs, we got hearts, corneas, we even got a pancreas. Hey, they said it couldn't be done, but we did it. Want a baboon heart? We got them. Cross-species transplants, llamas, baboons, pigs, great buys on bovine heart valves. Hey, we give you the atria and the ventricles. If you come today, we'll throw in a free supply of immunosuppressants with each organ. So head on out to the organ bin. Have a heart.
Hey, kids, look what I've got for you.
Mr. Sticky Buddy!
Okay. Yay! Deal, Grimith.
My kids are going
whacking over.
It looks like a stick.
Thank just you.
A stick,
all right, stand by, everybody. We got some new players here.
We got some new players. One more time. All right, take care, Callisto. Take care, Callisto. I will once again enable hosting. I will once again create a party. Oh, wait. Oh, that's like so you can get randoms to join you? That's no good. I'll play. And Linky. We even have a pancreas. That's right. I don't know if the old link will work, Grimith, so I'll just give you this new one. Boop. I'll also call you, too. Or you call me when you're ready. And we can have a third player if someone wants to join me in Grimith. Open invitation. If not, it's okay. We even have a pancreas. Lethal. Lethal. I don't need to. Oh,
there we are. I called you.
Oh, Lethal says. Oh, I've browbeated Lethal into joining us. Good. Good. I will add.
That's right. You're getting him at something he's weak at. Trivia. It's not his thing.
That's okay. That's okay. It's.
He does not fill his mind with useless data. It's all got to be about animu, food, racing,
Simpsons.
And video
games. Well, I appreciate you taking some sacrifice for having funsies. I gotta find Lethal, though. I guess you could add him to this conversation since you started it. So, also, we'll have to wait for...
Well, I mean, this is not a conversation. It's a DM between you and I.
Oh, shit, that's right. Okay. Shit! Okay, then I'll start a weird-ass conversation. Oh, wait, here, I can add friends to DM. There
yeah,
you go.
Yeah, you can add friends to DM. There
okay.
You go.
All right. You need to be friends with Grimith.
As a friend. My goodness.
I know. I guess we didn't have that option. Over
yeah,
here. Oh my Gorn. Now we can get Lethal in here.
Yep.
There he is.
I was gonna start broadcasting soon. What a great.
Oh God. Sorry. What were you gonna do?
Oh boy. Now
oh,
I gotta
boy.
Mute the stream.
That's right. You gotta mute the stream.
Yeah. Sorry. What were you gonna do, Grimith?
I'm going to be broadcasting soon after
oh.
this, so it's
oh,
going to be
perfect.
A nice warm-up for me.
Oh, good. Oh, good, 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 good. And then that's perfect. I'm going to eat my dinner while watching you. All right,
oh
so
goodness.
Now, Lethal, do you has Parsec installed?
No, I don't even know what that is. I actually looked at it with Grim like 1,000 hours ago.
Oh, sweet. Well,
back
I'll give you a link.
The Halcyon days.
Okay, here. Well, I'll give you a linky. Where is it? Where is Parsec?
I was going to say, I'm downloading
simple.
The Windows client now. Whenever you said link earlier, I'm all, wow, they upgraded, so I don't have to install things. This is great. How naive I was.
Yeah, no.
That's how naive you were, indeed. Yep, that, and make a free account, and then...
Account? That was
I know.
Not part of the fucking deal, God.
Yet. I
it's
know.
Really easy, I'm sorry.
He sends you an invite, and then you hot join off of him,
please.
And then... You hear yourself through his speakers, and you'll probably hear me twice. I don't know how that's going to go.
No, you'll only hear him once.
Well,
we'll see.
With 100% less spam, so are they sending me one email instead of two, or what?
They'll send you one email. Lethal, did I mention how much, how great you are, and how fun it is to hang around you?
Listen, I already know that. You don't need to tell me.
Okay. Did I mention how what a great of a cook you are? And how great you are at racing games and Wolfenstein?
As a roommaster, Lethal.
Oh, I already have an account. Well, hot shit. Let me go ahead and get that password.
Well, hot shit!
You must have forgot he did that when he looked at it 1,000 hours ago.
I didn't even realize I made an account there. Okay, let's try this whole login process.
Thanks,
Forgot my password. There you go. If it is this one, maybe it is just this. Let's see if I can hack my own account. I can't. Well,
oh, yeah, I'm going to be able to hear him twice in front of this. It's going to be great.
Oh, this is going to be so fucked up.
It is.
Okay, good. Log in.
I have a cunning scheme. What I'm going to do is I'm going to mute him on Discord.
Oh, that makes sense. That's at least one way. And now all you'll do is hear yourself for like a
second. I'm not going to be able to mute myself in real life.
Okay. No.
But if you muted me, then I would only hear myself one.
But if I muted you, no one would hear you.
Except for me.
Well, yeah, through your own ears.
Lethal would hear me too. He could tell you what I'm saying.
That's true. Okay, let's not overcome again.
Yeah, I'll be the fucking liaison for you two.
Oh, shit. This is amazing.
All right, I'm installing the client now.
Sure, so once you got the client installed, I will send you the link, and you can join, and I will enable it.
So I'm looking at the list of Discord servers you're in, eh? Why is mine so far down there at the bottom?
I don't know. Oof. Oh, awkward. I don't know. This is in the order in which I joined them, Grimith.
You have SKS's server above mine.
Yeah, that's because I joined his after yours. Okay, here, we're fixing this.
After mine?
There.
You joined his server after here. Mine.
There.
But they're
how's
in
that?
The order in which you joined, eh?
There's...
And
okay.
It was on top.
All right, here, I'm putting mine on top, and you'll be right underneath.
You didn't even have yours on top.
No, see? 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 So now you can feel better. You big baby. God damn it. There. Oh my god, Grimith. Oh shit.
Bless you.
Bless you. I don't know if that was the game or if one of you
said that. That was absolutely the game.
Okay, I've sent you a friend
request. Accept. Great.
It made a noise.
So now I can. Okay. Oh, here, this will be even easier. I can say. Okay. Well, I'll just give you the link still.
Okay.
And it will be here. There you go. And then
you better watch it, Inferno. I'm able to click on things.
No,
I'll
you
do
can't
it. Don't click on
No,
things.
I have I only gave you controller control so far. When we're ready, I'm gonna enable the keyboard for you in Lethal. Not before. I know how much of a rapscallion you are.
Ow. Grimith is a good boy, don't you
measure
him.
Yeah, huh? Alright.
Oh boy, I can see you and I can move things.
Alright, I just want to make sure my stream's still up. Okay, yes it is. Alright. Okay, just calm down. I'm going to enable keyboards. Now we're going to play.
Are you sick?
No, I'm okay. I'm okay. Just like a little cold or
now we're
going
to need some directions and instructions.
Names, okay? Yeah, right. For Lethal. Hey, yeah.
Alright, how you doing? All right. Welcome to the show. Blah, blah,
I've muted a Grimith,
blah,
so I should only hear one.
Hello, people. How you doing?
Great.
My name's Cookie. Welcome to our show here. How
Cookie.
Many people are going to be playing the game?
Three.
Yeah,
very good.
Oh,
Player One, why don't
three.
You tell us about yourself, starting with typing in your name?
Oh,
thanks. Now, Player
you be
two,
number two,
because
you're the player
now?
Two in my heart, Levo.
45 seconds.
There
right,
you go.
Player Three, you know the drill.
Number one, are we in?
Yeah, we're
okay, you want to do a 7-question game? All right, if that's what you want, you're called.
30 seconds.
Player One, your buzzer is Q. That's Q like quicksand. Player Two, your buzzer is the letter B as in bend over. And Player Three, you are the letter P, as in pastry plate.
A tea, or, you know, hot tea or something like that.
Hey, we're running out of time. Cue the commercial.
You know, we never had this kind of problem in Da Nang.
20 seconds!
Okay, heads up. Here's how the game works. The first one of you to buzz in on a question gets first stab at the answer. So you buzz in, and then you press 1, 2, 3, or 4, depending on which answer you want. You read me?
Okay,
okay, everybody be quiet. You're quiet now. Okay, lose the desktop. Cue graphics.
Fine, I'll be quiet. Then.
Okay, go to black.
I know it's super loud.
Barking billies, or your pet fat.
You're overwhelmed
gone.
By trivia. Jelly vision.
Jelly.
Butter vision. If you're good at other trivia games,
it don't mean jack.
It don't mean jack now.
It's time for the show where high culture and pop culture collide.
Alright, we got ourselves a trio, a triangle, a love triangle, a menage a trois. Mm-mm. Maybe I should lay out some newspapers.
No.
Yes.
Glad you're here. You know, it gives me something to do. Now then, what would a trivia game be without some weaponry? Let's pass out the screws. So here you go, giving all three of you one screw each for round one. Alright, hey audience. What do you do when your neighbor doesn't know the answer to a question? You got it. Screw him. Buzz in and hit the S key. It forces your opponent to answer that question. You got it?
Yep.
You guys ready to fly? It's time for blast off.
Whoosh.
Player 3, select a category.
It's number one.
This one's gonna be, you won't find that in the history books. And this one's going to be worth $1,000.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
We feel so excited.
Which of these pairs might have collaborated on the phrase, give me liberty or give me a break? Go for it, player two. Maybe you're thinking about the phrase.
What you talking about, Mr. Jefferson?
Well, if they were paired up, the Midnight Ride could take on a whole new meaning.
Oh, damn it.
Go for it, players Pat and Nelly. Of course, Nell could have given us all a break by killing that Joey kid before Blossom got started.
Beautiful.
Player three, pick a category for me. All right, let's see what we're doing here. English grammar and Dick's love life. You get this one right, you
what
got 2,000 bucks coming at you.
That was
flight
the
attendants,
someone's following me
take
sound.
Off.
Okay.
Yeah, according to standard grammatical rules, which of the following sentences uses the word sit or set incorrectly? Dick sat
Thank
on
you,
his lap, Dick had set himself down on the couch, Dick told Linda to set the veggie on the table, or Dick set up the harness for Linda? Player two, what he actually Dick had sat on the couch.
Oh,
there
shit.
Go.
Good job.
Yeah,
grammar lethal.
I know my grammar's at
least. Okay, good. Player two, let's do it.
Speaking of grammars.
Question three. The name of this category is Science in the Department of Corrections. Okay, this one might be a toughie. It's worth $3,000. Hang on tight, because here we go. If the warden of a prison wanted to put certain convicts in the Hadley cell, what would he need to do to them first? Fly them to the moon, make them lighter than air, inject them into a pig, or cut them in half? Player one, go nuts! Player one, who you want to screw? Player three, what are you going to do about it? Oh, I'm sorry, that's incorrect, but it was a really bad guess.
Really bad guess.
Player one, player two, who wants this puppy?
Damn it.
Go for it, player two.
I was gonna say, how do I screw?
Princess.
I don't.
You'd have to make them lighter than air.
There you go.
I'll just get.
Because the Hadley cell is an air current pattern.
You press S to screw someone over.
Let's have a category, S, player two.
There we go. My favorite rendition of four.
I did for you, Grimma.
Well, thank you, Overlord Darkwolf. I'm glad that you like
the category behind this question is a great joke at dinner parties. I'm paying out $2,000 if you get this one right. Get ready to buzz, because here it comes. At a cocktail party, someone tells you your friend is showing more than her fair share of aqueous humor. What should you do next? Congratulate her on her sparkling wit, tell her to chew with her mouth closed, chastise her for being insulting, or take her to the emergency room.
Aqueous, aqueous.
Player three, take it. Yes, I'd like to direct your attention to your score. Watch closely. Player one, Go for it, player one. Get her to the emergency room. Because she's got excess fluid in her eyeball. Player one, give me a category.
What? I don't understand. Explain it to me.
Uh-oh, mess butt tit slime chore.
Explain it.
It's time.
Oh, yeah. You know, your eye is made out of goop.
Is
aqueous fluid is
and anatomy.
That
the opening
goop.
Value is $5,000.
Yeah.
Okay, now remember, the faster you solve this puzzle, the more money you win. Now, you know there's no screwing your neighbor in this kind of a question. You ready to untangle some gibberish? Let's do it. What does this rhyme with? A nerd in the band biz dearth you in the tush. Player three.
What?
Time
oh, a bird in the turn. Hand. Shit. Wow.
What are you waiting for? If you're waiting for me to make some kind of a lame bush joke, it's not gonna happen. Okay, we need a category for player three.
Gotta be quick!
The category is, I got your fairy tale right here. And we are
got
talking 1,000
right
bucks
here.
For this
oh,
question.
I love it.
Okay, hang tight. Put your fingers on your buzzers. Here's the question. Hey, what actually happens at the end of Aesop's fable, The Boy Who Cried Wolf? Player one, go nuts. Spicy.
Aww.
Player two, player three, who wants it? Go for it. Man, what town did you grow up in?
I wanted to answer.
Player two, if you want it, it's yours. Player two, what do you say? That's right.
It's one.
That's
but
right.
I wanted it to be
true. Beats the
what kind of town did you grow up
okay,
in?
Okay, we need a category here.
Oh,
first, player
shit.
Two.
I wanted it to be true.
All right.
The category.
Stop all my game face
here. The periodic table. And this one's going to be worth $2,000. Okay, get your fingers ready. Let's get busy. If an MTV VJ were struck in the head with a large quantity of bauxite, what would be the most likely result? Asphyxiation? Player one, you've just been screwed. What are you going to do about that?
Ah, shit.
Player two, player three, want to take a stab at it? Go for it, player two. A splitting headache. Bauxite's the main source of
aluminum. I think
Lethal
was just
hey, we can
giving
dream,
us the slow
we?
Roll. Oh, I don't like trivia
game.
Games. I'm not
player
good
two,
at them.
Pick one.
You're still switching to a stupid question. You're still switching to a dumb question.
All right, let's see what we're doing here. There's no such thing as a stupid question. And it looks like you can win 1,000 greenbacks for this one. Okay, we're coming at you. Heads up. How many rings are in the three-ring binder? The remainder of 6 divided by 2 is 2. Half a circle's radius with a diameter of 6 or the square root of 9. What'd you major in outdoor recreation? Player 2, player 3, who wants it?
Oh, shit.
Square root of 9.
Yes.
Now you cipher better than Jethro Bodine. And he
oh,
done graduated the 6th grade. Player 3, select a category.
What did you call me?
Oh, this
one's going to be...
This is the best trivia game
me?
I've ever played,
this question's
going
to be worth $2,001 bills. Get your eyes focused on the screen. Here we go. Susie is polydactylous, meaning she has too many of what? Toesies.
Oh.
And these three little
Toesies.
Piggies went to college, and these four other piggies got a condo together, and these two... Player 3, pick a category for me. Here's the category. Anthro 101, Brady Culture. Right here, 1,000 bucks for a right answer. Okay, get yourself set, it's time. Of the following items, which would the Hawaiian locals say caused Greg Brady to have that surfing accident? A 15-foot wave, a stone tiki idol, a lei, or too many Mai Tais? Now the correct answer is the tiki. Bobby found the stone idol and gave it to Greg for good luck. Duh, Bob.
Didn't remember that episode.
Me neither.
I don't remember any episode.
All right, getting some screws out here. Ow, ow, put the pin in here, God. Okay, here we go, one for everyone. Now pay attention, because all the questions in round two are worth more money. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Player one, okay. Pick one.
I gotta do this one.
11!
Next up, chocolate and asinine cartoon characters. And like we are talking 4,000 like big ones. Imagine, if you will, a Kathy comic strip in which our noseless heroine has a bad case of PMS.
Okay.
Craving chocolate, Kathy finds a place that sells her a piece of chocolate that is 144 square feet in size. How big does... Player two, what do you say?
Damn it, he bugs before me.
12
yeah.
feet area is the product of the length and the width.
Yeah.
I pressed P and I was like, I buzzed in. And he's like, no. No. Wait a minute.
What do you say, player two? How about it? Uh-oh. West truck licks nine more.
Once again, it's time for
Junior Link test.
Test truck.
Here's your gibberish category. Snobby virgins and jokes about flashing. And if you're really fast, you can get up to $10,000 for this gibberish question. Okay, now remember, you don't have all the time in the world here. The less time you take, the more money you make. Okay, you ready? What tired old joke does this rhyme with? Overstep the pure Miss Pris Hoeing.
Oh.
Joke?
And number one, you're exposing something. Would you like a little stripper music? But don't be ashamed. It's player one, see what you got.
Yep. He even capitalized it for you.
Yeah. And he even spelled epidermis correctly.
Yeah, I know. I still got it.
It's a very generous parser.
Yeah, it is.
Player one, it's up to you. What are we doing?
Question 13.
The category, bogus beasts and Big Bird bar bets. A right answer will get you 2 G's for this question. For years, Mr. Snuffleupagus has been winning free drinks by betting that he knows the world's biggest bird. If you want Mr. Snuffleupagus to pay for the Mad Dog this week, what mythical bird should you bring to... Go for it, player two.
Damn it! I pressed P.
The medical rocks were said to bring home full-grown elephants to feed their young. Not only does
stop hacking my keyboard,
he's in danger of becoming breakfast for baby Huey. Okay, we need a category. Your pick, player two.
I can't even blame host because you're not host.
Yeah, exactly.
The category behind this question is food
probably
and identity
closer to
crises.
Meat.
And if you can figure this one out, I can pay you $4,000. Hope you're ready, because
yeah,
here's one coming at you. Who of the following is a real person? Mrs. Paul, Aunt Jemima, yes, I'd like to direct your attention to your score. Watch closely.
No, he was a real person. I will throw my keyboard at the monitor. That's not how his name was spelled. He spelled it that way because it was easier for people.
You gotta answer it, player two.
He was a real person!
Player one, the ball's in your
come
court.
On,
what
Bruno, there's two answers.
Go for it, player one. Mr. Duncan Hines.
He was a real person! This game is bullshit, fuck you!
Oh, watch Grimith lose his shit live.
Test notes.
Another one, okay.
Once again, it's time for
I mean, it was like B-O-I-A-R-D-I.
Well,
here's your category for this gibberish
question.
Chad
agrees with you, at least.
Look out, he's got a sweater. The opening value for this gibberish question is going to be $10,000. Okay, to solve this puzzle, you gotta think fast, because every second and a half, I'm ticking off a little bit of cash. Okay, ready? What TV song does this rhyme with? Don't screw knee-high labor. Okay, it's from a PBS kids show. Operators are standing by for
Magic School Bus?
It's about a guy in his hood.
Oh!
Yeah, that's where his
hood
is.
Oh! Oh!
Go for it, player one. Uh-oh. Type in your...
There you go.
Neighbor. You.
Can you say correct?
That's Canadian. Right. You spell neighbor with a U in Canadian land.
Friends.
Why you can't be in our country?
Oh my goodness, Kiss. He did.
Oh shit, it's my turn. dead things.
And I like it too.
And I like it too. This category is dead things. You get this question right, you pocket $6,000. Flight attendants, prepare for takeoff.
Which of the following Jurassic Park dwellers is the only dinosaur that actually existed in the Jurassic period?
Hadrosaurus.
No!
Blair 1, it's in your hands now.
Okay. I'm gonna go with my boy Triceratops!
Triceratops! Triceranot.
Aww. Shit!
Blair 2, Blair 3, wanna take a stab at it?
Oh, I think I know what it is now. I bet it's gonna be Stegosaurus.
And let's see the correct answer.
Yep.
Stegosaurus,
shit.
The cockroach of dinosaurs, it lasted for several periods of the Mesozoic era.
The official dinosaur.
Well, Blair 3 selected
official dinosaur of Colorado. I slurred there because I heard myself.
I do
the second category way. Is $1,000 for a snow job. You get this one right,
snow
you get
$2,000
right coming at you. Okay, help me out here. I just can't seem to remember this. What's the real name of that big, scary, cold guy? You know, the one who's supposed to look... Yeti, otherwise known as the Abominable
Yoda.
Snowman.
Clearly Yoda.
Now, personally, I don't believe any of that abominable snowman stuff.
All right, I'm back out of the negatives after that screw job.
Hey, you mind? Could you close the door and wipe your feet? Okay, we need a category from player three.
Oh, only a couple more questions left.
This one's gonna be, if you think that's big, you should see the whale. I'm paying out $2,000 if you get this one right. Hang on tight, because here we go. If Moby Dick were a country and western song, what would it most appropriately be called? If you want my Moby player, that's it, you got it. That's right, Ahab lost a leg in his initial encounter with the white whale, and now it's payback time.
Grimith ain't fucking around now.
Player three, pick a...
I was gonna say that's the one he's gonna pick.
Next up, Roman Orgy. And this one is not gonna be easy. $6,000.
Okay.
It's nearing the end of the millennium, and you're designing the invitation to your big New Year's toga party. The year of the party is 1999. How is that? Player two, what do you say?
Let's see. I'm gonna end with nine.
MCMXCIX.
Yep, that's right. I was hoping you'd screw one of us. Like it's
MCMXCIX. Nah, not when I can make games.
Category player two. Question number 20. All right, let's see what we're doing here. Beretta and reproduction. $6,000 is riding
on
this
one.
One
to get it
okay.
Right in front of the challenge with the jack.
If the girlfriend of TV cop Beretta managed to have a child with Beretta's pet Fred, what would the result be most similar to? Player one. Go
I nine. Just have to do it. Fuck, I don't know.
That answer, Sphinx.
Ugh.
Player two, player three, who wants it?
Now I have no chance.
Go for it, player. Fred was a cockatoo, so the resulting offspring would be... A harpy, the mythical half-woman, half-bird. Hey, it takes one to know one.
Jack attack time.
Player three, select a category.
Ooh. Drug nicknames. Oh boy.
All right, for newcomers.
Jack attack time. Soon as you see two words on the screen that go together, buzz in. $2,000 if you're right. $2,000 off if you're wrong.
Don't feasies.
Every time you're wrong. And careful, cause not all matches are equal. It's gotta be a match that fits this clue. A drug by any other nickname. Get yourself ready and remember that clue. Prepare for the attack now.
Bull trippy.
Oh, what? Nice. Get hosed.
He's lagging the game. He's slowing it down.
Oh,
he's cheating.
Lag on my side.
Oh, is there lag on your side? For real? Hello? Can you hear me?
I can hear you now.
Okay, I was with the... Oh, okay. So now it's all back. Because if there's lag on your side, then I guess it's cleared up now. So we'll resume now.
Okay.
Okay. Damn it. Old trippy.
Old trippy. Post. Post.
Player one, you steamrolled the other players, but the big question, what's your final score?
People didn't have to do player anything in order to win that, though.
Ah.
I blame Chef.
I just got—I missed that one to make it interesting.
Well, it's kind of a figure of speech. I mean, it wasn't that interesting, but maybe you'll find this interesting. You
don't know Jack. Stupid Chef Boyardee.
That would have been
okay,
the one that made
show,
it.
Cooking,
yeah,
what's
it,
here
it docked me the score for that.
Well, that was delightful, guys. Thank you. Oh, okay, that's it. You don't get to touch my keyboard anymore. God damn it.
I figured I'd just answer for you.
Yeah, fair enough.